In the last video, I showed you how to do a backtest directly in MetaTrader. And in today's video, we will look at how to build a portfolio from a backtest directly in QuantAnalyzer. To create a portfolio, you will use QuantAnalyzer. QuantAnalyzer can also be used in the free version, but there, this functionality is limited only to 4 strategies. However, this is perfectly sufficient for a basic portfolio. If you would like the full pro version, you can purchase it. However, you can also get it completely free with the ultimate version of Strategy Quant. But now, let's show you this functionality in practice. Switch to the Portfolio Master tab, where you will build your portfolio. First, I will explain the user interface and then show you how to build a portfolio in practice. I will also show you a practical tip on how to build a portfolio for different sectors. This will ensure that your portfolio is as diversified and variable as possible. You have 2 options to choose from: brute force or genetic search. Brute force will search through all possible combinations, while genetics does not have to search through all combinations. However, since genetics can significantly speed up the process, I recommend choosing this particular option. Within genetics, I recommend leaving the default settings. You can also specify in sample and out of sample. Out of sample is data not used in initial build. Then restart FitNest if in sample stagnates for 20 generations. This means that if the FitNest function stagnates for more than 20 generations, the entire process will restart and search for better combination. This means that it will search until you stop it. Click on recommended values. Then click save and let's continue. Here you can see how many strategies you have selected. You can then select the number of strategies here. Here you choose the minimum and maximum number of strategies in the portfolio. And you also specify the maximum number of portfolios that will be stored in the data bank. This depends on the capacity of your computer. If you have at least 16 gigabytes of memory, you can choose, let's say, 1000 portfolios. But if you have less, leave the original predefined value of 100 or 200. Here you also select which FitNest function should be used to select the optimal portfolio. I do recommend leaving the return drawdown ratio. You can also define so-called sectors. What does that mean? Sectors can be, for example, markets, different types of strategies, or any other categorization. For example, you can indicate that you want a maximum of 2 strategies from the Nasdaq market, a maximum of 2 strategies from the Dow Jones market, or that some strategies are of the limit type, others are of the stop type. And this will give you greater variability. You also have here the option to set the correlation. I recommend setting the maximum correlation to 0.15, let's say. In general, I recommend staying below this value. Of course, like, the ideal correlation would be 0, but this is very, very difficult to achieve. That is why it is important to have strategies from different markets. You can also specify how the correlation should be calculated. I personally recommend profit loss according to monthly. At the same time, allow negative correlation. This means that when one strategy loses, the other can profit at that very moment. Click on save. Leave the settings for empty periods at their default values and in the data range section, select full available if you want to use all available data. Next, set that you want a portfolio with a profit factor of at least 1.3. And QuantAnalyzer then will not create portfolios that do not meet this value. You could also set other filters here, but for this example, we will leave only the profit factor. Now we can start building the portfolio itself. Also, there is a button Create Portfolio, and this would start the process. Right now, I have here only one strategy, but for like a better illustration, I will add some more so we will have more strategies from more markets. When importing, make sure that the tick, pip, step and size settings are correct. It's very important. If you switch between different views like by money, by pips or by percent, then incorrect settings could affect the result. If you only want to track dollar values, you can kind of ignore some of these settings. However, I recommend setting them really correctly. For example, I set 0.1. Check that this applies to all strategies from the same market. For the Japanese yen, it's value 1 because it has no decimal places. Adjust the values for the S&P in a similar way. Now we have your strategies backtested and MT5. Now you could divide the strategies into sectors. For example, to keep it simple, let's choose it according to markets. So let's say it will be DJ for Dow Jones, then NQ for Nasdaq, and S&P, SP for S&P 500. Then specify that you want a maximum of one strategy from each sector and a minimum of three strategies in the portfolio. Maximum number is 6. Please remember that the larger the range you choose, the more combinations will need to be calculated. And of course, the more time it will take. We are all set, and now let's select the strategies you want to use and let's click on compute. Now the QuantAnalyzer will start creating portfolios. You can sort the results by profit factor and your individual portfolios. For example, here you can see that the markets are not completely balanced. You could adjust this before deployment using risk normalization. However, for the purposes of this example, this video, this is perfectly adequate. Based on the conditions we entered, you can see that the strategies are not correlated with each other. And most portfolios contain 3 strategies and each from a different sector, which is exactly what we set up. If you look at the specific results, you will see that the strategies complement each other well. Now, QuantAnalyzer is keeping calculating, and we can possibly refine the criteria as we go. The filter now only shows portfolios with a profit factor higher than value we set, 1.3. And here you could also add additional parameters. It's up to you and what you expect from the portfolio. Well, and that's all for today's video. If you would have any questions, please write them in the comments. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss any more videos. I look forward to seeing you again next time.